Buongiorno, Valentina Neri per Box Office. La domanda è per il signor Katzenberg. Durante questi mesi l'abbiamo sentita spesso dire meraviglie sul 3D e di quanto il 3D per lei possa rappresentare una nuova rivoluzione nel cinema. Mi chiedevo se le interessa anche la televisione 3D, visto che sappiamo che stanno sperimentando qualcosa, e se quindi nei futuri progetti della DreamWorks c'è un'idea riguardo questo.
I think that 3D television will be driven first and primarily by sports and by video games. I don't think that it, even with the new technology, which I think people will see later this year in terms of what you can do on a TV, it really doesn't compare to what we're able to do in a cinema. And so I think they'll be very, very different experiences. And I'm still most excited about reinventing the cinema experience for people today, for people who love movies and for people that have stopped going to the movies. I hope this is a reason to come back to the cinema, because you cannot do this in your home.
Io voglio chiedere se i figli del signor Witherspoon hanno visto il film e se l'hanno visto in 3D, che impressione gli ha fatto di avere la mamma eroina come supereroe in questa versione e poi in un film in 3D.
My children have seen the film. They saw it a few weeks ago and they loved this movie. This is the favorite movie that I've ever made. it's made me very popular at their school. And it was great. So my son is 5 and my daughter is 9. And we left the movie and we were driving home in the car. And I said, what do you think the message of the movie was? And my daughter said, very thoughtfully, she said, I think it's about never underestimating yourself and never letting anybody think less of you. And I said, I think that's right. I was nice to my son, who's 5. I said, what do you think it's about, Deacon? And he said, I think when octopus monsters invade your planet and they're aliens, I think that you need to kill them. And so I think they both really understood the film.
Prego.
Buongiorno, sono Andrea Daddio di Filmato. Ho una domanda per Mr. Katzenberg. Quando è venuto a Roma ha detto che probabilmente con il 3D, con gli investimenti che si dovranno fare nelle sale, il biglietto del cinema verrà un po' di più. Adesso la crisi economica, bene o male, leverà anche una parte delle spese, dei consumi in divertimenti. Pensa che potrebbe essere un freno per lo sviluppo del 3D, soprattutto nell'idea sia che gli esercenti spendano dei soldi per modernare le sale che per il pubblico di andare al cinema? Grazie.
Io non voglio ovviamente rubare la parola a Mr. Katzenberg, però quello che è successo in Italia e i numeri che Mr. Katzenberg sicuramente conosce danno un segnale opposto in Italia.
Cioè, in
termini sempre, prego.
Here's my feeling about that. Going to the movies today is literally one of the single greatest bargains that exist in the world. It costs more to go to a live theater, to a sporting event, to travel someplace on a vacation. As people look to stay closer to home and have to manage their finances more carefully, as we all must do today, movies become an even greater bargain. And we've seen actually in a number of countries over the last 3 or 4 months, the United States in particular, where box office has exploded. CinemaPoint in the United States over the last 9 or 10 weeks, which is from Christmas holidays till now, is up 17.5%, and for the first time in more than a decade, admissions are up 15%. To offer people a premium experience within this bargain of going to the movies, I actually think is very timely. Now, the good news is we're not denying somebody the ability to see the film in its traditional 2D presentation. And, you know, I couldn't be prouder of the movie any more than Madagascar 2 or Kung Fu Panda. I think it's as good a film as those films in its presentation, and most importantly, in its storytelling. Because the one thing that 3D will not do is make a bad movie good. And in fact, that's more what we tend to think of in the old days, is that it was a gimmick that tried to make something look good that really wasn't. And that's the opposite of what we're doing today. We're trying to take something that's fundamentally a great piece of storytelling and offer people a way to experience it that's really unique.
Paolo Scott, prego.
Buongiorno, sono Paolo Scotti per il giornale. Se la domanda è già stata fatta, mi scuso, io sono arrivato in ritardo. Volevo chiedere alcune informazioni tecniche. Sapere intanto in quante sale uscirà il film in versione 3D e se è previsto, come mi pareva di aver capito, che in alcune esca anche invece normalmente, cioè senza la distribuzione al pubblico degli occhiali. E che tipo di ritorno, ma in questo in qualche modo il signor Katzenberg ha già risposto, che tipo di ritorno economico si prevede in Italia? Da noi le curiosità, le novità tecnologiche destano anche molta curiosità, ma possono anche in qualche modo lasciare un po' sorpresi. Io la prova che abbiamo fatto noi un mese fa circa, io dopo un po' mi sono dimenticato di avere gli occhiali addosso, altri miei colleghi invece hanno lamentato una fatica anche proprio fisica nel sostenere questo tipo di impegno, come dire, ottico in più. Ecco, allora le domande quindi sono tre: in quante sale uscirà in 3D?
Noi abbiamo...
Okay, grazie.
Allora. So, number of movie theaters, when a film is released here in Italy, Madagascar 2, our last release, and I think our most successful ever here, and I think actually the most successful animated movie in Italy ever, was in about 550 cinemas, and we would expect about the same for Monsters vs. Aliens. Less than 10% will be in 3D. Cannot tell you how many. That's, we're right in the middle of having those conversations with the exhibitors. There are, I think, about 40 or 50 3D screens within Italy. How many of those will be playing the movie, I don't know yet. That will get decided in the next week or so. That was question one.
La seconda, qual è la sua aspettativa rispetto al pubblico, rispetto che il 3D possa...
La fatica,
sì, appunto, un elemento fatica, se lei pensa che qualcuno si possa stancare, una novità.
So we've screened this movie now many places around the world in 3D for many audiences. The reaction to the 3D has been sensational. People are very, very excited about it. Because of the quality of what our filmmakers are able to produce, the precision of the 3D images, and because digitally we are able to project it perfectly, the eye strain, which is what makes you tired, has pretty much been eliminated now with this new technology. The last thing, which I am actually very excited about, is I have visited here in Italy with Luxottica, the largest eyeglass manufacturer in the world, and I've met with the CEO of the company and have been working with their research and development team in California at Oakley, which is a division of Luxottica. And they are well on the way to creating a pair of glasses that when you're outside are your sunglasses, and when you're inside, they automatically transition to movie glasses. And so in a reasonably short period of time, I think people will come to own their own glasses that are fit for them and the style is something that's comfortable for them. So I think one of those stigmas...